Good morning, everyone. You're very welcome back to Age and Opportunities Movement Minutes with myself, Paul. I hope you're all well on this Wednesday morning and you're ready to join us for our standing session today. As you can see, we've changed location. I've come into the kitchen here this morning, but fear not, you're not going to be getting a cooking demonstration from myself. Probably the last person you should be taking a cooking demonstration from this morning. The reason I'm here this morning is that we're going to base this morning's session around simple but effective movements that you can do along your kitchen countertop or worktop whilst your kettle's boiling, okay? So it's our cup on tea or cup on coffee or cup on whatever you're having yourself routine this morning. And again, we hope that you'll join us for that. And I'd ask, just because this morning's session is a pre-recorded session, that if you're not already in your kitchen, that you just hit the pause button now, and then you can rejoin us when you take both yourself and your device into the kitchen, and you can place your device, as I've done here, just up on the kitchen worktop. So if you haven't already done that, I'll just ask you to pause the video now and you can join us when you're ready. And just to begin, I'm going to just take a nice wide stance position, so feet flat on the ground, slight bend of the knees, and we're just going to cross the wrists then across the front of the chest. I'm going to close down the eyes, and then we're going to take a nice deep breath in, raising our hands either up above our head or out in front of our shoulders. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale. And last time now, big breath in and blow it all the way out. And then when you're ready, I'll just slowly ask you just to open the eyes or open your own eyes. And then we're just going to start off just by gently just marching on the spot. Okay, just moving the feet just nice and easy. And again, you have your extra support in the form of the kitchen worktop this morning, should you need it. Okay, and then we're just going to march or move it out side to side. Okay, and as we do that then, we're just going to roll the wrists out in front, both just moving at the same time. And then again in the opposite direction for 3, 2, and one. We're going to come back into a light march on the spot again. Okay, so just barely lifting the feet and the knees up off the ground. We're going to place both our hands just at our sides, and we're going to bring our hands up in line with our shoulders and just slowly lower them back down by the side again. And we're going to incorporate movements to the front and then bring them out by the side to the front. And again, just out by the side. And then we're just going to alternate between the front and the side. And again, the hands are coming up no higher than shoulder height. And we're going to go for 3, 2, and last one. And just relax it down by the side then. Once again, we're going to plant the feet nice and firmly on the ground. And we're just going to run our hands down the outside of our legs. So just dipping down to the right hand side, coming back up, down to the left hand side and back up. Just nice and steady. Fingertips going no further than the knees. So we're not going past the knees. Ideally, we're going down as far as the knees and then coming back up. And we're just going to go for 2 more. And last one. We're going to put our fingertips on the kitchen worktop now, and we're going to lift the knees up a bit higher. Okay. So lifting the feet fully off the ground, taking the knees up a bit higher if we can. Again, just marching on the spot. For 4, 3, 2. And one, great stuff. We're going to place our hands then on our hips, again taking a wide stance with our feet, and we're just going to move our hips around in a circular motion. Okay, so pushing them out to the front of the body, both sides and behind, going clockwise first of all, and then just moving it around in the other direction, going anti-clockwise. Nice big wide circles for 3, 2, and last one. We're going to bring the feet together now, touch tight, hands on the knees, slightly leaning forward, and we're just going to move the knees around as well in a clockwise circular motion. Okay, so just bending and straightening the knees, just moving them around, and then going in the opposite direction for 4, 3, 2, and 1. We're going to stand it up nice and tall once more. We're going to hold one foot out in front, gently just lifting it off the ground, moving the foot around clockwise and then anti-clockwise. Same then with the other foot as well. So just drawing small circles with the toes in one direction and then just changing the direction then for 4, 3, 2, and 1. And we stand it up nice and tall again and just give the legs a little shake out. Okay, so that's our warm up done. We're going to move on now to three trios for a tongue twister on this Wednesday morning. 3 trios of movements that we can do while the kettle's boiling. Okay, so we start off boiling the kettle and we can do these 3 movements as the kettle's boiling. And once we're finished then, hopefully we'll be able to have a cup of tea or a cup of coffee. Okay, so our first one again, we're going to use the countertop as support. So both hands on top of the kitchen countertop, and we're going to step both feet back. Okay, just back a small step. We're going to have both heels in line. As you can see, we're going to be leaning slightly forward at an angle with our hands holding us up. And what we're going to do, we're going to lift one heel at a time. Okay, so the right heel, place it down, the left heel, place it down. And then again, we alternate then between the right and the left. So just pushing that heel, lifting it up first and then pushing it back into the ground. Lift up and push it back into the ground. And what this will do for us, it'll actually just give a nice stretch of the muscle on the back of the lower leg, which is the calf muscle. Okay, a very important muscle in our day-to-day lives and our day-to-day activities, particularly in terms of going up stairs or steps and just general walking about as well. And we're just going to go for 4 more. 3, 2, and last one. Great stuff. And then we can stand up nice and tall again. Okay, so that's number one. Number two then, we're going to move it on. We're going to have our countertop or worktop to our side. We can place one hand on just to get that extra bit of balance or extra bit of support. Stand it up nice and tall. And we're just going to move our outside leg, which for me at the minute is the right leg. We're going to move that out to the side. So just open up the legs and slowly take it back in. And again, this is nice and controlled. Just moving out to the side, slowly take it back in. And we're just going to go for 3 more. Last 2. And last 1. And then we're just going to turn it around. Okay, so we have our opposite hand now as support. Opposite leg now is going to be the outside leg. Again, we're going to stand it up nice and tall once more. Just move it out to the side, slowly take that leg back in. Okay, out to the side and back in. All controlled, not too fast. And we're just going to go for 2 more. And the final one, and slowly back in. Okay, if you want to make that a little bit harder, if you'd like to add something extra in, I'll just ask you to grab a cup from the press. Here's one we've made earlier, as I say in all the good cooking shows. So you put your cup on the outside hand or the outside arm, and we start off, and again as before, we move the leg out, but we're also lifting the arm up as well. Okay, and you can do this now, you don't have to have a cup or any sort of a weight. That's just for an extra bit of resistance. So as the leg comes up, the arm comes up again, just in line with your shoulder, and slowly down for 3, 2, And last one, and just bring it back down, okay? And we can place the cup away then for our cup of tea afterwards when we're finished. So we'll leave that to one side for the time being. Again, we're going to face our countertop or our worktop, both hands on this time, and we're going to lift both heels off the ground at the same time and slowly lower back down to the ground, okay? So up on the tippy toes and slowly lower back down. Make yourself nice and tall, hold it for a second and lower down, up again and slowly lower to the ground. And we're going to go for three more, last two, and final one, and slowly back down. Great stuff. Okay, so that's our first block of three movements, okay, for our cup on tea or cup on coffee routine. Our second block now, again, is going to be concentrated on the legs. And what we're going to do, just to start off, I'm going to start boiling my kettle here. And hopefully by the time the kettle is fully boiled, we'll have gone through our three movements. Okay, so our first one, again, with our sink or countertop fireside, just as support should we need it, we're going to take a step out with the right foot. We're going to lift the back heel and we're going to drop the back knee. And then we push off that front foot again. Okay, then we lead with the opposite foot. So step it out, lift the back heel, slowly drop the back knee a few inches towards the ground and push it back. And then we alternate between the right and the left legs. So just a nice step out, push back, step it out, lift the heel, drop the knee and push it back. And we're just going for two more now off each side. And last one off the right. And last one off the left. Great stuff. We're going to face our support now. Okay, so again, standing it up nice and tall. We're just going to lift the heels at the back, just one at a time. Okay, so we're just lifting them up, just in the general direction, just up towards the bum, or up towards the ceiling. So just one at a time, again, just nice and gentle, always in control. And we're just going to go for four, three, two, and one. And our final movement now in this little block, again, just having our hands on the worktop for support. Just make sure you have a good clear space behind you. We're going to point our toes out behind and we're going to drop that back knee again just a few inches towards the ground. So just dropping a few inches and then we stand it up nice and tall, dropping a few inches, back up nice and tall. Okay, so step back, drop, stand it up, step it back, drop, and stand it up. And again, we're just going one leg at a time, alternating between the right and the left. And we're just going to finish off now with four more in total. And our kettle should be boiled. And back up. And last one now. And there's the click of the kettle. And that's us done. Okay, so again, very, very simple movements. Just three there. Again, for the lower body or the legs that you can do while the kettle is boiling. The first three we've done probably would be more suitable to early in the morning because they're more just about stretching and opening up the joints and activating the muscles, okay, getting them warmed up in the morning. What I've just done there now might be more suitable to later in the day, you know, when you've been moving around for a while and you're properly warmed up. And our last three movements now that we're going to do is just mainly concerned with the upper body, okay? And there's one in there for the legs as well. So just to start off with our first one there, again, we're going to stand this time just with our back to our countertop. We're going to take a small step forward. We're going to relax our hands down by our side with the palms of our hands to our back. And we're just going to reach or move our hands back to tip the countertop. Okay, so just nice and easy, just moving it back. Now if you find that you can't reach the countertop, you might just need to take a small step back. If you find that you're too close as well, you can take a small step forward. So just moving both hands back at the same time. And we're just going to go for four more. That's three, two, great stuff. And final one, and just bring it down. We can turn around then just to face our countertop. And if you happen to have presses just above your kitchen worktop, there's two ways you can do this next movement. You can place your hands up on the cupboard or the press doors, okay? Just place them in front of your shoulders, feet firmly on the ground, and you're just gonna bend at the elbows and lower yourself down, okay? So just bringing your face closer to your cupboard doors and just pushing back. Might be the case that you have nice glass covered doors, okay, and you don't want to get any smudge marks or hand marks or finger marks on them. So you can, if that's the case, you can just place your hands again on the countertop, and we just lower this time our hips towards the countertop, and we stand it up nice and tall. Okay, so pushing back from the worktop and coming back up nice and tall. Again, just lowering down, pushing all the way up, and we're just going to go for three more now. Last two. I'll go zipper again, and all the way up. Great stuff. Okay, our final movement now, we're going to finish off with the legs, and again, just having our support by our side, giving yourself enough space to step into. We're going to step out with the right foot, lift the back heel, okay, and we're going to hold this position now. We're not going to move back, we're going to stay in this position, and the only way we're going to move is down and up. And how we move down, we lower that back knee again by bending the front knee. So lower the back knee towards the ground, stand it up nice and tall, lower it down, stand up nice and tall, okay? And there's no right or wrong distance here that you should be going down, just what you feel comfortable with. The best guide is just a few inches, and all the way up. And last time down off this leg and up, and we can step it back, step it out, lift that back heel again. Okay, and then we bend the front knee and we drop the back knee. Okay, and this one, your support can be at your side, it can be at the front, or if you're confident enough, you can just place your hands on your hips and try and keep your own balance. Okay, so again, just dropping that back knee, coming up nice and tall for three more. Last two. And final one. And then we just step it back. We just give the legs just a nice little gentle shake out. Okay, the arms as well, just loosen them out. So that's our trio of trio, folks. That's our three different sets of three different moves that you can do while your kettle's boiling, okay? If you even want to pass the time, as they say, a watch kettle never boils. So if you're not watching it, you can get your movements in as you're waiting for it to boil. But also these movements will hopefully have a beneficial role in your life then, in your day-to-day activities, okay? So again, as this pre-recorded, you can watch this back afterwards, maybe later in the day, if you're boiling the kettle, maybe you're boiling the spuds, and you can get your movements in with that as well. So just to finish off now, we're going to get our stretches as we normally do. Okay, so our first one again, making use of the worktop, we're just going to take a step back, and this time we're going to keep our head planted on the ground this time, okay? We're going to stand up nice and tall, and then we're going to slowly move our front knee away from us, and then we just hold that position. Okay, and you'll feel a nice gentle stretch just at the back of your lower leg. And then we stand it up nice and tall, opposite foot out behind. Again, plant the heel and slowly move that front knee away from you. And then when you can go no further, just hold the stretch in place. And we stand up nice and tall once more. We're going to come back now to what we were doing before. And we're going to lift the heel up towards our bum, and we're going to hold it in place this time, okay? We're not going to drop it down. And if you feel comfortable, you can grab the trouser leg or the leg itself just to lift that heel up a small bit higher. And then gently just lower the foot back down to the ground again. Opposite foot or opposite heel up now. Lifting up. hold in position. And then if you want to lift it up a bit higher, again, just grab the trouser leg or the leg itself. Slowly lower down. Okay, for our next stretch now, we're just going to take a step out in front, one foot behind, and we're going to bend this knee, okay? And what we're going to do, we're going to bring our hands up in the air, place them just above the bent knee, and we're going to lower again just a few inches, our hips towards the ground. So just imagine yourself sitting down into a chair. And we're just going to hold in place. And then we're going to curl that front set of toes just back towards us. Hold in place once again. And we stand it up nice and tall. Give the legs a little shake. Opposite foot in front now. Other foot behind. Hands up in the air and just place them above the bent knee. And just gently sit down into that chair. And we're going to curl the toes again with the front foot back towards us. Hold in place. And then stand it up nice and tall once again. And our final one now, just for the upper back, we're going to reach one hand out in front, grab it with the other hand, and we're going to reach as far forward as we can. And then we're just going to turn our hands around to the right hand side and hold. Back to center, over to the left hand side, and hold. Back to center again. And the last time now, we're just going to stand with our back to our worktop. Take a small step forward, bring the hands back just to grab the edge of your worktop, and we're just going to hold it in place now. So we're going to stick our chest out in front, and we're going to lift our chin up off our chest. Okay, and you should feel a nice stretch here just across the front of the chest. We're going to hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Just relax the hands down. Take a nice wide stance now. Once again, slightly bend the knees, cross the wrists across the front of the chest as we did at the beginning, and just close down the eyes. We're going to take a big deep breath in, raising the hands either above the head or out in front of the chest, and release, hands down. Inhale and exhale. And last time now, big breath in and blow it all the way out. And then just relax your hands by your side, keeping your eyes closed. Just move your feet closer together. Take a few moments for yourselves. And then when you're ready, you can just slowly begin to open the eyes. Put your hands together for yourself for your work this morning. Well done, folks. And I hope you enjoyed the change of scenery, I suppose, first of all, and also the movements that we had this morning as well. And I would encourage you, where you can and where you can remember being the important one, because I'm the same myself now, the best of intentions, but sometimes I just forget to do these things. So it might be no harm just to put up a little sticky note to have your cup on tea routine up beside the kettle, just to remind you to do it, because the more we do it, and those little pieces throughout the day, the more beneficial that it will be. And as the old saying goes, a little a lot is better than a lot a little. So if we can incorporate movement throughout the day, we'll get the most benefit from it. So thanks again for tuning in today. Barbara is going to be back here on Friday with the latest in her series of Tai Chi videos. And we've had some great feedback on that so far. So I hope you can join Barbara for that on Friday. And I'll be tuning in anyway. And also on Monday then, I'll be back for our live seated session here at 11 a.m. So you have my permission now. The work is done for this morning. You can go off, you can boil the kettle, have your cup of tea or cup on coffee or whatever you're having yourself this morning. Sit down and relax for a while. It's definitely deserved. And I hope you enjoy the rest of your week and your weekend. And we'll see you back here on Monday. Until then, stay safe and stay well. Thank you.